JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's weekly market outlook webinar for the week December the 28th until January the 1st. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will describe the most important economic releases and events on the financial agenda for the week ahead. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, this week the calendar is nearly empty, with the only releases on the agenda worth mentioning being the US pending home sales for November, due out on Wednesday, and China's official PMIs for December set to be released on Thursday. Friday is New Year's Day, and thus markets will stay closed. Now, because the 26th of December was on Saturday this year, Monday is Boxing Day in the UK, Canada, Australia, and New Zealand, with the respective markets staying closed. With regards to the data, we already got the Bank of Japan's summary of opinions from the latest monetary policy meeting and Japan's preliminary industrial production for November. The summary of opinions revealed that the bank is considering a comprehensive review of its framework, with the March meeting perhaps being the one at which it will lay out its findings. Officials also said that they must continue to keep an eye on risks, including abrupt moves in the FX market, which means that they will not hesitate to intervene if the yen strengthens too much. Thus, it would be interesting to pay attention to any speeches ahead of the March meeting for clues as to whether officials are planning to expand or not their stimulative efforts then, and if so, how will they do it? As for Japan's industrial production, its preliminary figure pointed to stagnation in November after a 4% month-over-month rise in October. There is no other worth mentioning data during the rest of the day, and thus market participants may keep attention on the U.S. political scene. Last week, the U.S. Congress voted in favor of a $2.3 trillion spending package, which includes $892 billion coronavirus aid bill, but President Trump refused to sign the proposal into law, insisting that it did not do enough to help everyday people. The emergency employment benefits expired on Saturday, while on Tuesday, a partial government shutdown was set to begin, putting millions of government workers' incomes at risk. Nonetheless, on Sunday, the U.S. president signed the pandemic aid and spending package, restoring employment benefits to millions of Americans and averting a government shutdown. The result was higher indices, higher equities during the Asian trading today, with the upbeat investor morale rolling into the European session. Now, on Tuesday, we only get the U.S. Conference Board Consumer Confidence Index for December and the American Petroleum Institute report on crude oil inventories for last week. The Conference Board Index is forecast to have risen to 97 from 96.1, while, as it is always the case, no forecast is available for the API report. On Wednesday, the only top-tier indicators on the schedule are the U.S. Pending home sales for November and the Energy Information Administration weekly report on crude oil inventories. Pending home sales are expected to have rebounded 0.2% month-over-month after tumbling 1.1% in October, while no forecast is available for the Energy Information Administration report yet. Thursday is New Year's Eve, and thus several markets of those under our radar will be closed, while others will close early. On the data front, we get China's official PMIs for December and the US initial jobless claims for last week. With regards to the Chinese data, the manufacturing PMI is expected to have ticked up to 52.2 from 52.1, while no forecast is available for the non-manufacturing index. Following February's tumble due to the economic damages due to the coronavirus, both the manufacturing and non-manufacturing indices have been consistently within the expansionary territory, signaling that the world's second largest economy continues to recover and perform well, despite other economies around the globe still feeling the effects of the fast-spreading virus. As for the initial jobless claims, they are expected to have increased somewhat to 835,000 from 803,000 the week before. Finally, on Friday, it's New Year's Day, and thus all markets under our radar will stay closed. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. I hope you have a great week, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next Monday. If you are interested in more detailed and frequent analysis, you can find me on our YouTube channel from Tuesday to Friday at around 7:30. At around, 8:30 a.m. GMT. So goodbye and have a nice day.
JFT, just fair and direct.